While rocket technology can date back as far as the 1st century BC, when the hero of Alexandria invented a device that could generate thrust from boiling water, the real history of rocket technology starts in the Second World War. The V-1 and V-2 rockets deployed by the Germans could travel more than 30 kilometers, and average speeds more than 5,500 kilometers an hour. That's about the same speed as modern-day cruise missiles. But after the end of the war, the US and USSR quickly snatched up most of Germany's rocket scientists, people like Wernher von Braun for the Americans and Eric Abel for the Soviets. From there, both sides rushed to produce ever more powerful rockets. Within days of the Germans surrendering, the Americans started Project Nike that would develop the US's first anti-aircraft missile system. And you can clearly see the inspirations from the V-2. The Americans basically said copy-paste and threw on some fins and an American flag. The rest of the 40s saw some minor rocketry improvements, with Chuck Yeager becoming the first man to go supersonic inside the Bell X-1 rocket-powered aircraft. But the real action started in the 50s and 60s, where both sides pumped out dozens of increasingly complex rockets. In a rapid fashion, in 1956, the US developed the first ballistic missile, the PGM-17. Launching from Cape Canaveral, it could travel up to 2,400 kilometers, or about as far as Minneapolis. Not anywhere near far enough for practical use. The next year, the Russians put one over on the Americans, launching the first ever intercontinental ballistic missile, the R-7, capable of delivering a payload to a target up to 9,000 kilometers away. From its launch pad in modern-day Kazakhstan, that put all of Europe under threat, and even the closest US states, like Maine and New Hampshire, just barely in reach. The Soviets could now launch an attack on US soil from the other side of the planet, and with its max speed at Mach 20, that means it could traverse the globe in just under 30 minutes, faster than most pizza places can get across town. That same year, the launch of Sputnik 1 would further cement the Soviets' dominance in the space race. But not too far behind, 3 months later in 1958, the Americans would do the same with Explorer 1. The 60s saw rocket technology progress just as fast, but now the goal was getting people into space. 1961, Yuri Gagarin became the first man to orbit the Earth. 1962, an Atlas D booster puts American John Glenn into orbit. 1963, Valentina Tereshkova becomes the first woman and the first civilian to orbit the Earth, remaining in orbit for nearly 3 days. 1963 to 1966 saw the development of the X-15, the first reusable manned spacecraft, the USSR Proton rocket, the FR Diamant, the first French and European rocket to reach orbit, the first successful lunar landing, and the first launch of the Soyuz spacecraft that still remains in service today, more than 50 years later.
I believe that this nation should commit itself to achieving the goal, before this decade is out, of landing a man on the moon and returning him safely to the Earth.
In 1969, although Kennedy wouldn't be alive to see it, astronauts aboard the Apollo 11 spacecraft were the first to touch down on the surface of the moon. 1981 would see the launch of the first space shuttle, and in 1988, the US's Deep Space One would be the first deep space mission to use an ion thruster for propulsion. These are the engines used today on Elon Musk's Starlink satellites and the Hayabusa spacecraft that return samples from an asteroid 2 billion kilometers from Earth. The day after Christmas 1991, the Soviet Union would collapse, but this left Soviet cosmonaut Sergei Krikalev stranded on the Mir, Russia's space station. Not only was he suddenly stateless, but with both his launch site and landing area located in the newly independent Kazakhstan, there was a lot of uncertainty about the fate of his mission. With the country that had sent him to space no longer existing, his return was delayed by more than 5 months. He's basically the real-life Matt Damon, just a little closer to home. The 2000s, with the threat of the Cold War no longer hanging over rocket scientists, became the millennia of commercial space travel. In 2001, American multimillionaire Dennis Tito became the first space tourist, coughing up $20 million to hitch a ride to the ISS. And from 2008 to 2014, we saw SpaceX launch the Falcon 1, carry astronauts to the ISS, and successfully land the first ever reusable rocket booster. Add in a few more advancements, and New Zealand launching its first ever rocket to orbit in 2018, and that's the history of rocket technology, all in under 5 minutes. Let us know what other topics you want to see explained in under 5 minutes down in the comments. And remember, there is always more to learn.